So, tonight is our soloist recital. We have 11 of your friends who are all brave enough to get up on this stage on their own, maybe with a little bit of help from the piano, and play or sing or dance or act and do whatever their talent is in front of you. A couple ground rules before we get started. When someone is performing, boys in the front row, my expectation is that you don't talk. You want to be respectful towards your friends, correct? So, when they're performing, pay attention to them. Don't talk. When they're done, then you can clap and cheer. I want you to encourage them. All right? This all making sense? I'm seeing some blank stares because all you half asleep, which is fine, I guess. But before we have our first soloist join me on the stage, I want to pray. So let's pray, guys. Heavenly Father, thank you for another day at camp. Thank you for the opportunity to learn and grow in both our music and arts gifts, but also in you. I thank you for the brave soloists who have decided to perform this evening. Be with them tonight, keep them calm, keep their nerves in check so that they can just get on this stage and sing and perform and dance for you. Be with us tonight, praise in your name, amen. All right, so first up this evening is Miss Helena from the Chico Corps. Helena will be singing and playing the ukulele, doing Good, Good Father.
That's loud. Okay. I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whispers of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, because you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. Love so undeniable, I can hardly speak. Peace so unexplainable, I can hardly think. As you call me deeper still, as you call me deeper still, as you call me deeper still into love, 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 love. You're a good, good father. to you are, to you are, to you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am.
Well done, Helena. It's not easy to be the first one on stage. Is that me? I don't know. I'm getting away from that speaker anyway. All right. Up next, we have a dance solo from Myla from Sacramento. Nicely done, Maya. All right. Up next, from the Concord Corps, we have Evan. No, we don't. I can read my own thing. We have a piano solo from Jeremiah from Sacramento. Come on, Jeremiah, you got this. Thank you.
Well done, Jeremiah. Nice job. All right. Now, from the Concord Core, we have a cornet solo by Evan Jones. Well done, Evan. For those of you in bronze band this week, practice. Couple years, your turn. All right. Moving along. Another dance solo. Over there. Wait, I'm missing my soloist. But Daislin from Sacramento is going to bring us a dance solo. Daislin. All right. We are nearly halfway there. And for something a little bit different, we're going to have Carter Boyd come on up and bring us a drum solo. Well done, Carter. All right. Now, you guys have done a fabulous job sitting and being quiet, other than when it's appropriate to cheer. But I think it's time to let you blow off a little bit of steam. I need some CITs and I need some program team to come up here and help me. Just come on, I'm not gonna do anything ridiculous that you haven't done already every day this week. Hit it. Stand up. Guests, we do this every day. Just go with it.
The way it's gonna be, the world is gonna see. A little bit of heaven in my life. A picture here of you, help me to be true. A little bit of heaven in my life. May I be a bright star shining.
Take a seat. If we've proven nothing to our guests, we've proven that y'all can sing. All right. Moving along, we will have a vocal solo from Miss Emily McCaig from the Concord Corps. She can't sing if you're yelling.
All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all. Each little flower that opens, each little bird that sings, He made their glowing colors, He made their tiny wings. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all. The purple-headed mountain, the river running by, the sunset and the morning that brightens up the sky. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all. The cold wind in the winter, the pleasant summer sun, the ripe fruits in the garden, He made them every one. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all. He gave us eyes to see them, and lips that we might tell how great is God Almighty, who has made all things well. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them, Lord God made them, the Lord God made them all.
Nice job, Emily. And I have to say, we have one other accompanist this evening, but we must give credit to the accompanists. That one in particular, they fought over who would have to do that one. So it takes a lot of work to help our soloists out. All right. I have been on music camp staff in some capacity for 18 years, minus two for COVID, so 16 times. And this is the first in my memory that we have had a beatbox solo. Whoop, there it is.
Thank you.
Well done, Leah. All right. I put my program down, so can someone with a slide tell me who's up next?
Me.
Let's look. There we go. Miss Tamisa McCart, you're up. Good job. All right. Next, we have a monologue from Miss Savannah.
Underneath his breath. I wanted to shout at him, that he looked like an overgrown skunk. But I was paralyzed with fear, scared, unable to move. While Skunk Boy had everyone laughing at me. To make matters worse, we were poor, very, very poor. My clothes were far from trendy. No Forever 21, no Macy's, no Nikes, just thrift store. The morning of my first day in fifth grade was a very, very bad morning. Recess was after lunch, after I was sitting on a bench, pretending to be interested in the amps. Darn. Alex approached me. He sat down and told me his name. Hi, my name is Alex. And my brother Darnell worked at the gas station after school and could get us any kind of candy. My favorite candy was Snickers. Alex and I became friends. Alex lived in a trailer and I was poor. And we were poor. So we had an understanding of sorts. We sat on the bus, copied each other's homework, swapped secrets, and shared bubblegum. Sixth grade turned out to be a great year after all. Throughout seventh grade and eighth grade year, we were inseparable, unable to move, unable to be without each other. We rode in Darnell's truck, in Darnell's 1955 Ford truck. That's when we smoked candy cigarettes, drink root beer, and sing really bad country music. We had bad taste in music. We were two pieces apart, inseparable. Wearing shoes with holes in them. The only thing that separated was our faith. I believed in God. He really didn't. He didn't mind. I was always talking about God. I have big dreams to be a missionary one day. Alex said he'd visit me wherever I went. We entered high school that autumn. We were secretly scared to death, but we stuck together. We were in the marching band. He played the trumpet. I played the clarinet. Our sophomore and junior year flew right past us, and we were suddenly seniors. He made the wrestling team, and I made the varsity basketball team. And I also made other friends. Candy cigarettes turned into real cigarettes. Root beer turned into drunken store burns on weekends. The rides on the floor were replaced with convertible with the popular crowd. Without Alex, my dad got a better job, which meant I wore better clothes. Alex still wore hand-me-downs from his brother Darnell. And Alex was now the brunt of jokes at the lunch table. Silence became our language. He still rode the bus and I drove a Jeep. Sometimes I would drive by Alex's house, wanting to stop, but couldn't. Wanted to somehow find my friend again, but I couldn't. My new identity left me. It rained on graduation day. Alex graduated with honors, and I barely made it through. I could still see him on the platform giving his speech, his words ringing out sharply, piercing me in my heart. Authenticity, live the life, yes, to thine own self be true. And it hit me hard. I really know who he was. And I absolutely lost myself. I ran to him after the ceremony, grabbed him, and began to apologize for the last year of my insensitivity and shallowness. He stared at me for a very long time, and then there was silence. If you are what Jesus Christ is all about, I would never, ever be a part of it, ever. And that was it. He walked away. He didn't look back. My mother called me in my dorm last night and told me that Darnell had committed suicide. He was married, had a little girl. I tried calling Alex, but then he heard my voice. He hung up the phone. You know, it was Alex's final words to me that shook me to my core of faith, driving me to my knees. Hard to speak, causing a real intercounter with the living God. I found grace and forgiveness. I ached to thank Alex and begged his forgiveness all at once. His honesty was my lifeline. Now I want to throw him one and thank. So Alex, if you're listening, thank you.
Well done, Savannah. And our final solo of the evening is our last dance solo, Malaya. Before I let Major Jeannie come give her devotions, soloists, on your feet, face your friends. Campers, one last round of applause. Well done, everybody. You can go take a seat.
Good job. There is a lot of talent in this room. Some of you did stuff I would never be able to do. I would probably hurt myself. But with that said, there's a little video I want you all to watch.
What if you didn't understand what he saw?
Then you better figure it out, because it was coming for you.
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno. Bruno says it looks like rain.
Where did he tell us?
In doing so, he floods my brain.
I will like the umbrella.
Married in a hurricane.
What a joy to stay, but anyway.
We don't talk about Bruno.
No, no, no.
We don't talk about Bruno.
I'm impressed, but not surprised that you all know those words. I have heard this movie over and over and over again because I have grandkids, and they're just the ages of you guys here at camp, and they love this. And for a long time, I wondered, why don't they talk about Bruno? So I decided tonight I'm going to talk about Bruno. I'm going to talk about Bruno. Absolutely. You know, they didn't like Bruno because Bruno told them things they didn't want to hear. And because they didn't want to hear it, they pushed Bruno out of the family life. So where did he go to live? In the walls and under the house, huh? They were so mean to him for telling the truth. That's what's really hard about this. You know, when you hear this whole song, they talk about Bruno being like 7 feet tall. But when you actually see him, he's not. He's just this little guy, nice, quiet spoken, but they made him out to be a devil. And there's a big word here, they ostracized him. Ostracized him means they wouldn't let him be a part of the family anymore. I agree. Am I spoiling this for somebody? Spoiler! Spoiler alert! But the reality of it was, they didn't like him because he was honest with them. He would tell them that if this is going to happen, and when it did, and they didn't like what happened, then they got upset. So I have another question for you. Do you know someone that's a Bruno? Evan's a Bruno. At least this was what his friends are saying. I bet you there are kids at school who you don't like. Am I right? We're being told we're not going to talk about that. We're done talking about Bruno, but the reality of it is sometimes we act like Bruno's family and ostracize people because we don't like the way they look or the way they talk or they're just not cool enough to be part of our social group. How can we do that? It hurts. Have you ever been on the receiving end of treatment like that where people push you away? And then you became that person. Thank you. The reality of it is, I don't think there isn't any one of us in here that at some time or another has not been unkind to someone else. I want you to think about that. Think about school. Think about your family. Think about your next door neighbor. And what have you done that might be unkind? Because in reality, our human nature sort of pushes it us to do things like that. I know at school there was a, and this was a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, there was another girl, I just couldn't stand her. She didn't do anything. She didn't act badly towards me, but there was just something about her that rubbed me the wrong way. And when she tried to reach out to me to be my friend, oh no, I wasn't having any of it. And the reality of it is, we choose to be kind, or we choose to not talk about Bruno. And we need to remember that that is not what Jesus asks of us to do. Jesus really gives us some, well, let's hope I can find it now. Okay, here we go. Jesus really gives us some instruction in a book. You know what the book is? The book is?
The Bible.
And in Ephesians 4:32, he says, be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. Remember those times when you might have been the one that they wouldn't talk about. But remember the times that you decided to be like the family and to push people away. You need to remember that it hurts. And you need to remember that Jesus wants you to be that kind, compassionate, forgiving person so that you can talk about Bruno. And you can talk to Bruno. That's a great movie. And I hope you've learned as you're out here at camp that it takes all these different people to make up camp. Now, we saw some beautiful dances tonight. I can't do that. But you know what I can do that many of you can't do? I talk about Bruno, but I can balance a budget. We all have different skills. We all have different personalities. And sometimes we might rub each other the wrong way. But we have to remember that God loves us, and we in turn need to love those around us. And I would encourage you, when you go back to school and you see that kid that gets sort of pushed away, become their friend. Show them Jesus loves them. And I hope that you continue developing these skills that you have, because they're fabulous. But more importantly, I hope you develop and maintain and increase that relationship with Jesus. That's the most important thing. We're going to talk about Bruno. We're going to talk about Jesus. Pray? Should I pray? Okay, let's have a word of prayer together. Father God, even in movies, we can see how we can be a person that loves other people, and we can learn lessons from it. And Father, I pray for each of these young people in this room. They have an opportunity to reach out to those who are hurting in their schools, in their families, and show them that kind, compassionate love of Jesus. Help them to remember Bruno and how his family pushed him away and how much that hurts. And remind them to be just like you and pull people towards themselves so that they can show them your love. We're just grateful for tonight. We're grateful for the talent in this room. And we pray you'll bless each one of us. In Jesus' name, amen.
All right, did you guys enjoy tonight? We have some very talented people up here in the front row. Let's give them one more hand. All right, and let's all stand up for Taps. We don't have a fire pit in here, so just put your hands down here in the middle. Day is done. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we are absent one from another. All right, go ahead.